He's one of the best athletes ever to wear a Packers uniform and one of the best guys ever to live anywhere in the state of Wisconsin. He is Donald Driver, our guy. Good afternoon, Donald.
Good afternoon. What's going on?
All right, let's talk about this game on Sunday. The Niners are no pushover. They are undoubtedly a very good football team, and it just didn't happen for the Packers on Sunday. Break it down for us a little bit. What happened? What went wrong?
Well, I just think, you know, they came out a little bit more fired up than we did. You know, we started out, seemed like we was going to start the drive off pretty good, and then, you know, we didn't convert on third downs, and then next thing you know, we get into this shootout, and we started making mistakes. And when you start making mistakes, that's when you're going to lose games.
Donald, this
is... We made some mistakes in that game that, you know, we tried to come back, and when we tried to come back, it was more in the fourth quarter.
Donald, this is Bears Week. You have been through this so many times. Now your 14th year in the league. Is Bears Week still special? Your thoughts?
It's always special, you know, especially when you're fighting against a rivalry that's been going on for a long time. I think we have played those guys 185 times. So, I mean, it's always going to be a battle. I mean, I remember sitting back at home watching the rival between the Packers and the Bears before I even became a Packer. So the tradition is going to always be there.
You didn't play much Sunday. We're not part of the game plan on Sunday. Your thoughts on that, and will you be more a part of the game plan this week?
Well, I hope so. You know, that's the biggest thing. You know, I came back this year to play football, and, you know, my number wasn't called this week, so I'm hoping my number gets called this week.
I want to ask you about the replacement refs, Donald. Eric and I had the chance to go back and listen to what you said about the replacement refs. I think it was last week or maybe the week before. And you were very polite like you always are. And you said, well, we're going to hope for the best. You know, those guys are there to do a job. And I'm paraphrasing, but, you know, I think it'll be all right. I was at the game on Sunday. Those dudes were terrible. What's your take on how things went from a referee perspective?
It didn't go the way we wanted it to go. I can promise you that. You know, the thing about it is, you know, you go into a game, and one thing it is, you gotta sometimes try to play above everything else. And that's the game plan going into this week, is that you gotta play above the refs, you gotta play above all the stuff that shouldn't happen. And what we gotta do now is just go out there and play our solid game. If we do that, we're gonna be fine. So that's the problem. We feel like we didn't do this, you know, this week just passed.
From a player's perspective, is the player's health at risk because of the replacement refs?
Is the players at risk?
Yeah, are the players' health? Is your health at risk because sometimes these guys don't know what they're doing?
Well, I think it's a surprise to them sometimes. You know, the game is so fast. Some of these officials are like Division I, Division II, Division III, you know, officials. So the game, from playing in those type of levels to playing in the highest level that you can play in football, is much different. So, I mean, I think the game is so fast for those guys. I mean, we're talking to some of the officials during preseason. That's what the first thing they will always say, is that the game is much faster than the college game. So, you know, I think, you know, they're looking out trying to protect everyone, but also, you know, guys are getting, you know, they're not making some of the calls that we feel that, you know, should be called.
So, Donald, TMZ was reporting that Aaron Rodgers had made a bet with Boys to Men, and that if the 49ers had won, that Rodgers would have to wear a 49ers jersey this week. Have you seen him walking around wearing a red shirt?
No, not at all.
Did you know that your buddies in Boys to Men were San Francisco 49er fans?
I've known the Boys to Men for a while, as well as Aaron. So, I mean, they came to the show when I was doing Dance with the Stars and got a chance to meet them. But, no, I knew Nate was a 49ers fan, and I didn't know Aaron made a bet with him, but that's crazy.
You didn't make a bet with him, did you?
No, not at all.
Hey, Donald, Dancing with the Stars gets started here again in, I think, just a couple of weeks. PETA is one of the favorites again. Are you going to be watching?
I will be watching. The 24th, that'll be, my eyes will be glued to the television.
You think you'll make any appearances out there?
Probably next season, the summer. I'll probably do make an appearance on the show. But this time, I probably won't.
Now, we can all agree you were clearly the best dancer ever to be on that show. Will you be cheering for anybody this time? Emmett or Apollo Anton Ono or for PETA or what?
I'm pulling for PETA and Gil. That's what I'm pulling for. So I've talked to Cheryl. She said you better be pulling for Emmett, but I can't pull for Emmett because Emmett was against me early in the show.
That's right. Absolutely. He is Donald Driver. It's a short week, Donald. Stay healthy. Go get him on Thursday.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.